I'm Jimmy Sledge as we get set for today's ball games with East Central Oklahoma University, the Tigers of East Central. We'll have the women's game here at 1 o'clock, men's game somewhere around 3 this afternoon. And we'll hope you'll stick around. If you want to, come on out and join us. But can't make it, we'll just keep listening to the radio. We'll have all the play-by-play for you here this afternoon. Again, we welcome you to our broadcast. Women's game at 1, men's game at 3 here today. In the women's action, the Tigers of ECU come in 4-7 overall. And they are 1-6 in conference play. They picked up their first conference win of the season Thursday night over in Magnolia at Southern Arkansas. The Blossoms are 5-8 overall, 2-5 in conference play. They did pick up their second conference win on Thursday night against Southeast Oklahoma, but it was the first for Coach David Midland. He was absent on their first win back on December the 17th. Good to see them pick up that win for him on Thursday. Both teams are out on the floor taking their final preparations before this afternoon's ball game. And again, we invite you to come on out and join us here at Stillman Fieldhouse. It's too cold outside to do anything else, so you need to come on, stay warm, and watch some basketball in person here at Stillman Fieldhouse. We'll take a break. We'll come back with more in just a moment. Again, we welcome you back here to Stillman Fieldhouse. We get set for this afternoon's ball game. The Tigers of ECU and the Blossoms of UAM going at it here this afternoon. Take a quick look at the starters for you. First of all, for East Central, they were starting guard, a freshman out of El Reno, Oklahoma, Ashlyn Evans Thompson. At guard, a 5'6 sophomore out of Moore, Oklahoma, Kennedy Cummins. At guard, a 5'8 redshirt senior out of Elgin, Oklahoma, Izzy Cummins. At forward, a 5'11 senior out of Baldwin City, Kansas, Kate Ogle. And at guard, a 5'7 junior out of Choctaw, Oklahoma, Mackenzie Crusoe. For the Blossoms, same original five that Coach Midlick has been starting. As it will be at forward, a 6'1 junior out of Suriname, Sierra Kinsmo. At forward, a 5'11 sophomore out of Sassy's, Texas, Bailey Harris. At forward, 5'9 junior out of Marion, Arkansas, Joy Montgomery. At guard, a 5'9 freshman out of Memphis, Tennessee, Alindy Long. And at guard, a 5'6 junior out of St. Louis, Missouri, Azari Hulbert will get the start for Coach David Midlick and Assistant Coach Marissa Webb as they are all set to go. Everybody's getting lined up for the national anthem. Again, we invite you to come on out and join us here at Stillman Fieldhouse for this afternoon's ball games. But if you can't make it, just keep it right here on KHPM 93.7 FM. I'm Jimmy Sledge, and we'll do our best to give you a good play-by-play description on the radio as everybody gets where they need to be, and we're just about set. We'll take a break. We'll come back with more right after this timeout.
Fans, welcome to Stillman Fieldhouse as visiting East Central University is hosted by your UAM Bloodhounds. At this time, we ask that you please remove your hats and stand for the playing of the national anthem, played by the pride of Southeast Arkansas, UAM's Pet Band.
Welcome back on this Saturday afternoon to the campus of the University of Arkansas at Monticello, Stillman Fieldhouse. We get set. Great American Conference basketball coming up is this afternoon's game at 1-3. We're back at home on Thursday. It'll be 5:30 and 7:30 next week, and then on the road to Arkadelphia to play Henderson State after that next 1 week from today. So that's kind of the schedule you can start planning next week if you want to come watch some UAM basketball. You can do it at home next Thursday or travel up to Arkadelphia on Saturday to watch us take on Henderson State. Teams are being introduced onto the floor. I'll quickly go over the starters again for you. For the Blossoms, Sierra Kinsmore, Bailey Harris, Joy Montgomery, Alenzi Long, and Azaria Hulbert. It was Thursday night, coming off the bench, Lyra Bissell's really showed out. She had eight steals in that ball game that really turned things around for the Blossoms to pick up that win on Thursday night. For East Central, Ashton Evans, Kennedy Cummins, Lizzie Cummins, Kate Ogle, and Mackenzie Puso will get the start. As their head coach is the interim coach, Heather Hurt. Lindsay, no! Started the season, I believe, if I got the story right, he was selected through the interview process and selected as the athletic director.
Number 32, Azaria Hulbert!
The assistant coach, Heather Hurt. I think they did that at midterm, actually. She has taken over as head coach, and then the assistant is Jeff McGahey, and they have a graduate assistant, Hannah Ladd. So we're set for basketball. Both teams have been introduced onto the floor. They're getting their final instructions from their coaches. We invite you to come on out and join us at Stillman Fieldhouse this afternoon. If you can't make it, we'll keep it right here on the radio for all the UAM basketball this afternoon. see here.
Administrative technical foul for one of the shot clock lights not working.
As Sierra Kinsmel will go center jump for the Blossoms. It'll be Kate Ogle for the Tigers of ECU. We're waiting for the officials to step in with a basketball. And there. All right, they're gonna have a one-shot technical foul against the home squad for a clock violation. So at the line for ECU, it's gonna be Mackenzie Crusoe, and she will make it. And just like that, with no time off the clock, ECU has a one-point lead. And they're explaining things to Coach Midlick a little more in detail, I believe.
All right, Blossoms fans.
Over there, but it's 1-0 in favor of ECU.
Let's cheer
on our
Blossoms as we get this game started!
Looking back to a one-point lead. All right, we're ready for the jump ball at center court. Opening tip is going to be up and controlled by the Tigers of ECU. Pulling it down is Kennedy Cummins. To give it up to Thompson, Evelyn Thompson. Ashton Thompson. Back off, it goes to Cuso. They work it around the perimeter. Blossoms open up in a man-to-man defense. They'll try to go down low in the block. Shot put up, no good. Maybe partially blocked in there by Kinsmore. Blossoms will come out with it. Joy Montgomery into the front court. Gives it on the left wing to Bailey Harris. She'll drive to the baseline. Kick it back out front to a Lindsey Long on the elbow. Back out front, right side. They'll work it now. Azaria Holbert. Into the lane. Shot put up by Kinsmore. Will not go. Gets her own rebound. The follow put back up and in. Yeah, Kinsmore. Gives the Blossoms a one-point lead. 2-1. Now a whistle and a quick foul going to be called against the Blossoms. Foul's going to go on Azaria Holbert. Her first. First team foul against the Blossoms. Tigers will inbound on the baseline. They'll get it in to Kate Ogle. Ogle out deep on the right wing. Thought about the three. She's guarded by Kinsmore. She gives it up to Evelyn Thompson now. Top of the key. Bounce pass down low on the left side of the lane. Can't do anything with it. Kiss it back out front. At the top of the circle, a drive down the left side. Cummins goes in. Lost the handle on it. Goes out of bounds. It'll be a turnover against the Tigers of ECU. So the Blossoms get it back with 8:45 to play here in the first quarter, leading 2-1. Azaria Holbert takes it coast to coast, goes all the way to the baseline. Now to Kinsmore. Kinsmore had a pass deflected. It's stolen away. Turnover Blossoms down the floor. Izzy Cummins pulls up, waits for her teammates to get there. Gives the Blossoms a chance to get back on defense as well. Got a whistle and moving screen violation called against the Tigers as they're going to get Izzy Cummins. He tried to set up the screen for the three ball for Mackenzie Crusoe. Official right there called the illegal block. Blossoms with it back, leading 2-1. Bailey Harris goes along the baseline. And they're going to call her for an offensive foul. A little push off as she drove down the right side of the lane. Officials aren't messing around here this afternoon. Still 2-1. Blossoms with a one-point lead. Tigers with the basketball, front court. 8 minutes left to play, first period. They work it around, get it off to Cuso. Ball stolen away, another turnover by the Tigers. Blossoms get it back. Azaria Holbert goes all the way underneath the basket. Spin move, finally gets a shot off. May have got away with the travel. Loose basketball on the floor on the rebound. Lindsey Long chases it down. Out front to Bailey Harris for three, and it's good. Lady was left all alone out there. She nails the three, and the Blossoms have a four-point lead. 5-1. They'll try to answer on the other end with a three of their own. Shot put up will not go. Lindsey Long got the rebound. And let's see. They're going to call it on Lindsey, I believe. Yep, the foul's going to go on. They were both going for the rebound. They called an offensive foul. Called a charge. Coach David Midlick He's got one of the officials over there bending her here, but I don't think he's going to get anywhere. The Tigers will inbound it on the baseline. They'll get it in to Kate Ogle. Ogle gives it up out front to Cummins. Kennedy Cummins will swing it right side. Back out to Ogle. Ogle goes to Thompson. Thompson, a little floater in the lane. Good. Ashlyn Evan Thompson makes it 5-3. Blossom still lead. We go to 7 minutes left to play. Laya Basales checked in at that last timeout. Zaria Holbrook went out. Bailey Harris penetrates to the free throw line. That gives it back up, and they're going to call a 3 second lane violation against the Blossoms. 5-3. UAM with a 2 point lead, just under seven to play, first quarter. Blossoms staying a man to man. The Sales will guard Thompson. As over and back, good defense by the Blossoms, and throw it goes off the fingertips of Ogles and into the backcourt, so the Blossoms are going to get it back. Joy Montgomery is going to sit down now, and coming in for the Blossoms is going to be Nia Banks. Banks, a junior out of Tulsa, Oklahoma, getting her first action this afternoon. The Sales will run the point. She goes to Bailey Harris on the left elbow. Harris draws the double team. She'll kick it back out to Basales. Basales goes to the right elbow. Now gives it up to Lindsay Long. Lindsay off the Banks. Right corner it goes to Basales. Eight to shoot. Basales finds Kinsmore at the free throw line. A floater from there. Good. Kinsmore with four, and the Blossoms lead it by four again. Matches their biggest lead so far here in the early going. With 6 minutes left to play, first quarter. Tigers on offense. Work it right side. Now out front, they'll get it off to Thompson. Thompson goes right back inside to Izzy Cummins. Back outside. Now in the corner, three-point shot on the way is no good. Basales chases down a rebound for the Blossoms. Here comes UAM down the floor. Basales gives it up to Banks. Banks goes to the top of the key. Swing it back right side to Basales. She'll dribble up to the elbow. Picked up her dribble. Goes back to Banks. In the corner, they get it to Bailey on the left side. Bailey Harris takes the dribble. Penetrates inside the lane. The floater from eight will not go. Rebound chased down by the Tigers of ECU. 7-3 our score. Blossoms with the lead. Kate Ogles out on the left wing. Long cross-court pass, and there's a whistle. We're going to have a foul called against East Central's Kennedy Cummins, and she took the brunt of that. She was setting up the screen. Banks ran over her, but they called the foul on ECU. First personal on her, second team foul against the Tigers. 5-12 to play here in the first quarter, almost halfway through this first period. Blossoms with a four-point lead at 7-3. Montgomery came back and in the ball game. Joy takes it baseline, gets double-teamed, kicks it out front to Basales, off the Banks on the left wing. Back right side now to Basales. She'll take it all the way to the baseline. Into Aaron Hawkins. Hawkins travels to it. Blossoms turn it back over. With 4:49 left to play here in the first period, it is 7-3. The Blossoms have a four-point lead. We'll take a break and be back with more UAM basketball in just a moment. 7-3, the Blossoms with the early lead here. We're just a little over midway through the first period. Shooting numbers right now, East Central 1-4, 25%, 0-2 from downtown, and 1-1 from the free throw line. The Blossoms are 3-6, 50% from the floor, 1-1 from beyond the arc. Have not shot a free throw, rebounding. Blossoms with a slight edge, 4-2. Turnovers are even at 4 apiece. But the Blossoms have 5 points off of those turnovers by ECU. It'll be Tiger basketball out of the timeout. They'll work it left side to Cuso. Back out top of the key now to Cummins. Cummins for three. Make that Thompson. Thompson for three in his skill. 7-6. Blossoms lead cut to one. Maya Versailles. Shea Goodwin checked into the ballgame at the timeout. Goes to Montgomery. Montgomery travels with the basketball before she puts it on the floor. So we've got Nia Banks, Lia Basales, Joy Montgomery, Aaron Hawkins, and Shea Goodwin on the floor for UAM. Let Bailey Harris going back to the scorer's table, set to check in. First opportunity. Tigers with it, working around the perimeter. Blossom staying a man to man. They try to go inside. It's going to be the
basketball.
Travels with the basketball. The Blossoms will get it back. All right, Bailey Harris will check back in. Azari Holbert will come back in as Banks and Basales will go out. So on the floor, we've got Holbert, Montgomery, Harris. Kinsmith check back in as well, and Shea Goodwin. Blossoms with it, go baseline, back outside. Goodwin for three, it's off the mark, no good. Montgomery keeps it alive. And the shot clock has not reset. They're going to put it at 11, I think. And UAM will inbound here on the sideline. They put 13 on the shot clock. That last shot did not touch rim. So the Blossoms inbound it with 12 to shoot now. Try to get it inside to Kimball. Ball deflected, stolen. Down the floor, they'll pass it to Thompson. Thompson misses the layup, and the Blossoms have a rebound. Azaria Holbert quickly comes back on the other end of the floor. Go to Montgomery in the right corner. Joy pulls up, 14-foot jumper, no good. Rebound, East Central has it. Pulling it down is Emma Epperly. 7-6, our score, and there's Azaria Holbert with a steal. Azaria all the way, coast to coast, puts it up and in again. Blossoms lead at 9-6 now with 3:05 to play here in the first quarter. Tigers working around the left side, go left side of the lane, turn around jumper, put up, no good. Rebound, Blossoms have it, outlet pass down the floor to Kinsmore, and she'll put the left-handed layup up there. How about that? Blossoms with their biggest lead here in the ballgame at 5. It's 11-6. Blossoms on top, 2:38 left to play in the quarter. Tigers with it, that's Thompson. Thompson gives it up top of the key to Cuso. Swing it right side, they try to pass inside the lane. Overthrow, the intended recipient of it, Emily Wilson. Get another turnover against the Tigers, and the Blossoms are going to get it back with a 5-point lead. And 2:26 to play in the first quarter. Lia Basales checks back into the ball game. Also coming in, Alexis Grice getting to see some action here in early going. She's a junior out of College Station, Texas. Bailey Harris with the dribble, goes to the free throw line, pulls up, jumper from there, will not go. Rebound, Tigers have it. ECU with it into the front court. Throw it over in the left corner, out on the left wing. Now three-pointer on the way from Wilson, will not go. Rebound goes out of bounds. Last touch by the Tigers of ECU. The Blossoms will get it back with 2:01 left to go here in the opening quarter. 11-6 our score. Turnovers are mounting up on both sides, though. All right, Blossoms with it, front court. They work it around the perimeter. Basales at the top of the key now tries to the elbow on the right side of the lane. Gives it up to Kinsmore, and she'll travel with it. Another turnover against the Blossoms. 11-6. Blossom for the 5-point lead. A minute 40 to play here in the first quarter. East Central, Cummings, guarded out there by Basile. Goes right side to Ogle. Kate Ogle. Bounce pass inside. Now a whistle and a foul going to be called against the Blossoms. The foul is going to go on Sierra Kinsman. That'll be her first. The fourth team foul against the Blossoms here in the fourth. A minute 28 remaining. Blossoms still leading 11-6. Tigers inbound it. 15 to shoot now as the shot clock counting down. Izzy Cummings gives it up to Kate Ogle. Back out top of the key. She'll travel with
Blossoms basketball.
Oh, my goodness. A minute 17 to play. Blossoms are going to get it back. On the floor for UAM, Alexis Grice. Lindsey Long back into the ball game. Bailey Harris, Sierra Kinsmel, and Laya Basales. Laya with the dribble out front. Tries to find Harris going across the lane. Throws it away. Stolen by ECU. They'll get it back out front to Ogle for three. It will not go. Rebound. Blossoms have it. We're going to have a whistle and a foul on the rebound for a push-off. We're going to call it on Alexis Grice. That is her first, team's fifth, so they'll shoot the 1-1. Just under a minute left to play here in the first quarter. And the Tigers of ECU are going to be at the line shooting. Shooting two shots. At the free throw line, going to be Emily Wilson. The foul went against Alexis Grice. And let's see. Two shots. First one down the way and no good. Wilson misses the first one. Still 11-6. Blossoms with a 5-point lead. She makes the second one. So 11-7. With under a minute now left to play here in the first quarter. Blossoms, Bailey Harris will control the point, running it. Goes left side, back out front. Aaron Hawkins, a wide open three. It won't go. And the Tigers get the rebound. Kennedy Cummins pulls down the rebound for the Tigers. She'll bring it into the front court. Goes over on the right wing with a pass to Cummins. Izzy Cummins into the free throw lane. Back outside now. They'll keep it from reset. Back up near midcourt. Long pass over in the left corner goes to Mackenzie Cuso. Cuso guarded there by Bailey Harris. Then they try to go inside and a whistle and a foul going to be called against the Blossoms. It's a foul going to be called on Joy Montgomery for reaching around. It's going to put Wilson back at the free throw line with 22 seconds remaining here in the quarter. Free throw by Wilson is up, and it's good. She's now two out of three from the line. Second free throw coming when they give her the basketball. 22.8 seconds on the game clock. And not sure what they're working on. All right, they give it back to her. Here we go. Second free throw's up, and it's good. That's almost like icing the shooter, though, the officials are, by taking so long. She makes the second one. It's 11-9. Blossoms still lead by two. They can hold it for the final shot. Azari Hulbert, Joy Montgomery, Bailey Harris, Aaron Hawkins, and a Lindsey Long on the floor. Azari starts the move at nine. Hands it off now to Joy Montgomery. Montgomery drives to the elbow, right side. Gives it up to Hawkins on the left side. She'll go down the lane. Shot put up and a whistle and a foul. Charging call on Aaron Hawkins. Now, Aaron kind of out of control, went into the double team. They had set up the real estate inside, and Hawkins shaken up on the play. She went to the floor pretty hard with 1.3 seconds left to play in the first quarter. And foul went against Aaron, so her first personal. They're still tending to her out there on the floor. The trainers are out there. 11-9 our score. And Aaron's going to have to come out of the ball game. Looks like Sierra Kinsmo will check back in. Let me give Aaron a round of applause as she walks off slowly. The Tigers will inbound in the backcourt, 94 feet away, with 1.3 seconds left. Trailing by two here at the end of the first quarter. All right, we're set for action. Here we go. We get it in. Thompson tries to put off a shot at the buzzer. It's no good. At the end of one, the Blossoms of UAM, 11. The Tigers of ECU, 9. We're back with second quarter action for you in just a moment. Nine, the Blossoms have a two-point lead. And UAM shooting 5 of 12, 42% from the floor. They're 1 of 3 from downtown. It's 33%. Blossoms have not been to the free throw line here in the first quarter. For East Central, they're 2 of 9. That's 22%. 1 of 4 from beyond the arc. And they are 4 of 5 from the free throw line. That's 80%. Turnovers, 8 for the Tigers, 9 for the Blossoms. Rebounding, the Blossoms, 7. ECU with 6. We'll get set for the second quarter of basketball here at Stillman Fieldhouse. Come on out and join us. Stan, glad you're with us here on the radio. To nine. All right, on the floor for the Blossoms is going to be Bailey Harris, Azaria Hulbert, Joy Montgomery, Sierra Kinsmore, and a Lindsay Long. Original starting five starting the second quarter for Coach Midlick. Blossoms get it in. Go to Montgomery. She goes to the baseline. Back in the corner, it goes now to Harris. Bailey goes inside to Montgomery. Montgomery gets a shot to go. Montgomery with her first 2 points of the ball game. Blossoms lead at 13-9. The ball's going to be knocked out of bounds. Last touch by, nope, they're going to call a foul on Sierra Kinsmo. We saw her getting foul trouble the other night. And she had to sit out most of the second and third quarters. She picked up her second personal here. 9:37 to play in the second period. Tigers will inbound it. They get it into the front court. They got it to Izzy Cummins. Cummins guarded out there by Long. Give it up over on the right side. Now back out top of the key. Swing it around the horn. Left side. Over to Wilson. Wilson. Left-handed shot put up. No good on the left side of the lane. Montgomery with a rebound for the Blossoms. Joy will take it down the floor. Goes all the way into the paint. Outside finds a Lindsay Long for three. It's no good. And chasing the rebound down, Sierra Kinsmo does in the corner. Off to Holmer, back in the corner now to Bailey Harris on the left side. Underneath, they get it to Kinsmo. Kicks it outside and throws it away. Turnover against the Blossoms. Turnover number 10 Lia Basales is going to check back into the ballgame now for UAM. As Azaria Holbrook will take a breather. 13-9, Blossoms lead it 5-4. Three-point shot on the way for the Tigers is no good. Basales pulls down the rebound for the Blossoms. UAM set up in their half-court offense. Go to Bailey Harris. Harris gets a man in the air, drives the baseline, misses the shot, a whistle and a foul called. Bailey's going to get to go to the free throw line and shoot a couple of free throws.
That foul is going
to be number 14. The foul goes on Kate Ogle, her first team foul of the second quarter. Taylor East will check into the ballgame now for Sierra Kinsmore for UAM. Taylor, a junior out of Houston, Texas. Bailey Harris at the line. First one's on the way, and it's good. First free throws of the ball game for UAM. Here with 8:33 to play in the second quarter. Second free throw is up, and it's good. Bailey got them both to go, and the Blossoms have their biggest lead in the ball game at 6 now. 15-9. 8.5 to play. Second quarter. Tigers looking at this man-to-man defense. Try to get with a shot. It's blocked by Taylor East, and it goes off the hands of the Tigers, Mackenzie Busso, and the Blossoms will get it back. Taylor 6'2". He's the tallest Blossom on the team. All right, Blossoms have the basketball. Bailey Harris takes the dribble, goes to the left side of the lane. And now a whistle and a foul called on the floor. As the foul is going to go against Emily Wilson, her first, second team foul against the Tigers. So Blossoms get a fresh 20 on the shot clock and will inbound it. Get it into Harris at the free throw line. Right corner it goes to a Lindsey Long. Long shot, no good. Rebound fought for, a whistle and a foul called. They're going to call a foul. Goes against Mackenzie Crusoe. These officials called all the fouls on UAM in the first quarter, but working on calling on all of them here on the Tigers in the second quarter. Joy Montgomery will go out. Check it in. It's going to be Nia Banks now for the Blossoms. Banks will trigger the inbound with just under 8 to play in the second quarter. Lindsey Long got into the lane, got cut off, gets it back outside on the wing over here on the right side to Bailey Harris. Harris double team, goes to Basales. Now to Banks, left corner for three, rims out, no good. Tigers come out with a rebound. 15-9, Blossom still lead by 6. Tigers with it in the front court. Get it off to Izzy Cummins. Cummins with the dribble, goes right side to Crusoe. Crusoe
trying. Blossoms basketball.
UAM's going to get it back. That'll be the ninth turnover of the ball game against the Tigers. 10 turnovers against the Blossoms. We've got a timeout called on the floor. With 7:29 left to play in the second quarter, it's 15-9. Blossoms have a 6-point lead. We're back in just a moment. Blossoms with a 6-point lead. They've got a 4-0 run here to start the second quarter. We got 7:29 left to play. It'll be UAM basketball. I'll shoot out of the timeout. UAM will have it. Bailey Harris, Laya Basales, Lindsay Long's on the floor, Taylor East, and Naya Banks. Bailey Harris, right side, 16-foot jumper, no good. Rebound, going to be out of bounds. Last touch by the Packers. UAM will get it back underneath their own bucket with 17 on the shot clock. That shot didn't hit the rim. So the Blossoms inbound it, get it into Basales. Maya finds East in the lane. East post up, turn around, fadeaway jumper. Good. Taylor East, her first two off the bench, and the Blossoms lead it by 8. And now on the other end, we've got a whistle, and let's see. Not sure what the whistle's about on the other end of the floor. Game clock, or it's a shot clock issue, I believe. They'll put 25 instead of 28 on the shot clock. Shea Goodwin checks back into the ballgame for the Blossoms. Tigers with it, front court, working around the perimeter. Get it off to Thompson. Thompson, left side, three-point shot on the way, no good by the Tigers. Shea Goodwin down with a rebound for the Blossoms. Shea across the timeline, she's going to be fouled out here at midcourt. And the foul goes against Kennedy. Number 12, it goes against Izzy Cummings. And that is her second personal foul. The Blossoms get it back in the front court now. Maya Basales directing traffic. Long cross-court pass to Montgomery. In the corner, it goes to Goodwin. Goodwin travels with the basketball. Took steps before she put it on the floor. 6:34 to play in the first half. It's 17-9. Blossoms have an 8-point lead. Biggest lead of the ball game for them. Thompson with it now for the Tigers. Gives it up to Weiberg. Weiberg. They go inside the lane, turn around. Now Wilson. Wilson can't get the shot off. Kicks it in the corner to Thompson from the right side. No good. Rebound. Blossoms have it. Lyle Basales. Pass all the way underneath to Taylor East. Left-handed hook shot is up. In and out. No good. A whistle and a foul on the rebound. And let's see who they call the foul on. Foul is going to go against Jaden Weiberg. Weiberg. And we'll put to the free throw line. Let's see. Blossom's going to be shooting the bonus for the remainder of the half. At the line is Joy Montgomery. Free throws up, and it's good by Joy. A 9-point lead can stretch it to 10 with this free throw. 6:07 to play before half. Montgomery's second free throw is up, and it is 4 points here in the first half. All of them here in the second quarter for Montgomery. The Blossoms have a 10-point lead. East Central lost a handle on it. Ball's knocked out of bounds. Last touch by the Blossoms. Thompson lost a handle on it. Montgomery going for the steal, knocked it out of bounds. Azaria Holbrook will check back in. Laya Basales is going to come out. So the Tigers will inbound into front court. They'll get it into Mackenzie Crusoe. Crusoe gives it up to Thompson. Thompson penetrates, goes into the lanes. And ball's going to go out of bounds off of UAM. Azaria Holbrook knocked it out of her hands and out of bounds. The Tigers will get it back with 16 on the shot clock to shoot. To get it in, they finally do. Out top, they got it to Cummings. 10 to shoot now for the Tigers. Cummings picked up the dribble, needs some help, finally gets rid of it to Wilson. 3 to shoot, 2 to shoot. They're not going to get the shot off. They put it up, shot clock violation. Good defense by the Blossoms. Tigers didn't realize that the shot clock had not reset. They'll turn it over. There's a timeout on the floor called by ECU. We'll take it with them with 5:35 to play in the half. 19-9 our score. Blossoms lead it. We're back in a moment. 5:30 left to play here in the first half. Blossoms with a 10-point lead. Azaria Hulbert takes it down. And then the lane puts the shot up. Azaria Hulbert with 4 points now for the Blossoms. Gives them a 12-point lead on the other end. Counted and one as Thompson goes in. Gets the basket to go and draws the foul. Foul went on Azaria, I believe. That's her second personal. Ashlyn Evans Thompson got the basket to go. She's at the line trying to complete a 3-point play here. Free throws up and it is good. It was 11-9 at the end of the first quarter. The Blossoms have outscored them 10-3 here in the second period so far. 5:10 left to play. Lady Harris with it in the lane. Turnaround jumper in and out, no good. Rebound, Tigers come out there. Down the floor, coast to coast, Cummins. Kennedy Cummins goes up for the shot and a whistle and a foul called against the Blossoms. And the fouls will go on to Lindsay Long, her second personal. And at the free throw line, going to be Kennedy Cummins. Misses the first one. So after they went 4 of 5 in the first quarter, they're now 1 out of 2. One more free throw, making 2 out of 3 from the free throw line for the Tigers of ECU. Nia Banks going to check in. Joy Montgomery is going to come out. So we've got Harris, Basales, Banks, Taylor East, and a Lindsay Long on the floor for UAM. Lia Basales running the point, gives it back up to Banks. Off to East. East wasn't ready for it. It goes off her shoulder. That'll be another turnover against the Blossoms. 4:46 remaining here in the half. 21-13. Blossoms lead it by 8. Tigers with a chance to cut into that lead. Here's a 3-point shot on the way. It will not go. Rebound. Basales pulls it out of there for the Blossoms. Wyatt quickly down the floor ahead to Banks. Banks goes into the lane, lost a handle on it, gets it back. Now finds Harris, right side to Long. In the corner to Banks again. They'll reset the offense here. Long to the elbow, off to Basales, wide open looking at three, and it's good. Wyatt Basales, her first three of the game. And the Blossoms lead it by 11, 24-13. There's a whistle out in the front court. Going to be called on Lia, trying to reach around. That'll be her first. Team foul number 3 here in this second quarter. So they're going to inbound on the baseline. It's not the one. It's not the bonus. Everyone for East Central thought they were shooting free throws. Officials finally get them gathered up. Corey Hamilton will check into the ballgame now for the Blossoms, seeing her first action today. She's a junior out of Crum, Texas, became eligible to walk on at midterm. As the Tigers inbound, they're going to call a foul on Joy Montgomery. It'll be her second, fourth team foul. I get the 15 foul at the free throw line. Kennedy Cummins, she'll make the first one. Makes it 24-14. Still 4 minutes, 2 seconds left to play here in this first half. Second free throw's on the way, and it's good. 24-15. Blossom still with the lead. And they'll have the basketball in the front court. Lia Basales to Long at the top of the key. Right side, there's going to Shea Goodwin. Shea out on the wing. Takes the dribble, goes left side to Basales. Basales penetrates and it'll travel with the basketball. Trying to back in, trying to do just a little too much of it. It'll be a turnover against the Blossoms. Tigers will get it back and a chance to cut into this 9-point lead now. Go top of the key at the free throw line to Cummins. Down inside, they'll work it underneath. Shot put up, no good. As that was Wilson with the shot, could get it to go. Blossoms have an outlet pass on the floor to Harris, running the floor. She'll put it up and in good. Rayleigh Harris with five, make it 7 points here in the first half. And the Blossoms lead it by 11 again. And now a foul called against UAM. See who the foul was on. And everybody's got one. At the free throw line is going to be Kennedy Cummins once again. She's three out of four, make her four out of five. She missed her first one. Now she's hit the last four in a row. Makes it 26-16. Blossoms still lead by 10. Second free throw is up. It is good. 9-point lead for the Blossoms now. 3:15 to play in the half. The Sales running the point. Over on the screen from Montgomery. Gives it back up to Bailey Harris at the top of the key. She'll drive left side of the lane into a double team. Going to have a travel call against Bailey. Got into the double team. And already picked her dribble up and shuffled her feet. Blossoms lead it by 9, 26-17. Tigers with the basketball in the front court. They work it off to Cuso, McKenzie. Back out to Thompson. Thompson goes to McKenzie. Now the ball batted away by Laya Basales. Picked up by Lindsey Long. The Blossoms have it back in the front court. Pass goes in the lane to Long. She'll kick it in the left corner to Montgomery. Montgomery, a floater along the baseline. Shot won't go. Thompson comes out of the rebound for the Tigers. She'll go coast to coast. Left-handed scoop shot's up, no good. Long has the rebound for the Blossom. She'll take it down. She'll wait for her teammates to come out. As they get it off, Tori Hamilton fires a three. It's no good, but a whistle and a foul on the rebound for pushing off inside. The foul is going to go against Emily Wilson. Her second personal. Going to put Bailey Harris at the free throw line with 2:18 to play here in the half. Well, the last four minutes have gone forever, it seems like. Bailey at the line. 7 points in the ball game already for her. First one's up and good. Make it 8 points. Gives the Blossoms back a double-digit lead at 10, 27-17. One more free throw to go. Free throw is up, and it's good. She got a bunch of good. 28-17. Blossoms back on top by 11. Matches her biggest lead here in the first half. Thompson with it for the Tigers with the dribble, working against Azaria Holbert. Kicks it back outside to Ogle. Ogle. Got the key to Cummins. Left side of the lane, he'll go to Cuso. Cuso back in. They're going to call a whistle and a foul against the Blossoms, Bailey Harris. Crowd didn't think so. Crowd really not happy with the call, but it's going to put McKenzie Cuso at the line. All right. Stop the clock, too, with just under 2 minutes to play. First free throw is on the way. Good. Second point of the game for Cuso. He's our best free throw shooter on the team. Second one is up, and it is good. So 28-19. Blossoms lead it by 9. Just under 2 minutes to play in the half. Lindsey Long with it. Throws it to Montgomery. Ball batted away in the backcourt. Montgomery chases it down, gets it back for the Blossoms. With 15 to shoot. Corner to Holbert. Holbert. It's good. Azaria Holbert. Her first three of the game. The Blossoms lead it by 12. The biggest lead, 31-19. Ogle with it for the Tigers on the other end. Gives it up to Cuso. Cuso in the lane, spin move, shot off the glass, in and out, no good, rebound. Blossoms have it. Bailey Harris comes down with a rebound. 1:15 to play before halftime. Blossoms lead it by 12. Harris going to take it all the way to the baseline, bring it back out front now. She gets it to Lindsey Long. Tigers have gone to a man-to-man. There's a Lindsay off the dribble with the shot. It's good. Lindsay Long. Her first score to Blossom lead it by 13. 33. Made it by 14. 33-19 with less than 45 seconds to play in the half. There's a long three pointer by Ogles up. No good. Offensive rebound. The putback by Cummins. A whistle and a foul on the putback. Fouls and you're on Joy McGovern. Her third personal foul. With 38 seconds left to play before halftime, there'll be 8 seconds difference between shot clock and game clock. Back at the free throw line, Mackenzie Crusoe. She's 3 out of 3 from the line. Taylor East checks back into the ball game as well as line up a sail for the Blossoms. Crusoe makes the free throw good. Makes it 33-20. Has one more to go. She's perfect. 5 out of 5 from the line and makes it 33-21. So about 8 seconds difference between shot clock and game clock. Lion Vassales, Bailey Harris, Joy Montgomery, Taylor East, and Lindsay Long on the floor. Leah Vassales with it out here in the front court with the dribble. Gives it up now to Harris. 10 to shoot on the clock. Harris starts her move down the right side of the lane, pulls up, running floater from 8. Bailey Harris, he's in double digits with 11. Quickly down the floor, Ogles for 3. No good. Rebound, Taylor East, Blossoms. Blossoms can't get a shot off. We head to halftime, and the Blossoms lead it by 14. Their biggest lead of the ball game. 35-21. They outscored the Tigers of ECU there in the second period, 24-11. Blossoms go in at halftime with a 14-point lead, 35-21. We'll take a break. We'll come back with our halftime activities for you when we return in just a moment. Our score here at the half, the Blossoms have a 14-point lead, their biggest lead. They've led the entire game. Before we started the game, the Tigers got a 1-0 gift to them. It was a technical foul called against the scorer's table for a shot clock violation. So they led 1-0 in the early part of the ball game. Blossoms have led since then, and they now lead 14 by 14, 21-35. Blossoms with the lead over the Tigers. Don't forget, men's action will be coming your way. About 20 minutes after the conclusion of the women's game here this afternoon, so I hope you'll join us for that. Stick around. Want to come on out. Watch the men's game this afternoon around 3 o'clock when tip-off is scheduled. Looking at the numbers here in this ball game. For the game, the Tigers have struggled. They're shooting 14% from the floor, 3 of 22. They only hit one field goal there in the second period, but they went 10 of 11 from the free throw line. For the ball game, they're 14 of 16 from the free throw line, 88%, but 3 of 22 on the day from the floor. The Blossoms, 13 of 28, that's 46%. 3 of 9 from downtown, 33%. And the Blossoms are perfect at the line, 6 out of 6. UAM outscored them 24 to 12 in the second quarter to take this 14-point lead. It was only a two-point ball game at the end of the first quarter, 11 to 9. We end up with a 35-21 deficit for the Tigers here at halftime. Turnovers, 10 in the ball game for ECU, 14 in the ball game for the Blossoms. Rebounding, we've out-rebounded them by 8, 19 to 11. And the Blossoms have been able to turn those 6 offensive rebounds into second chance points of 9 here in the first half. UAM doing a pretty good job everywhere except the turnovers. I'm sure Coach Midlick will address that at halftime. 35-21 our score. We'll take a break. We'll be back with a look at individual numbers for you here at the half when we return in just a moment. Welcome back here to Steelman Fieldhouse on the campus of UAM. The Blossoms have a 14-point lead, 35-21 here at the half over the Tigers of East Central. And we'll look at individual scoring for you. Been far and few between for the Tigers, except from the free throw line, where they are 14 of 16 shooting free throws today. And look at that. Leading the way with 8 points is going to be Ashlyn Evan Thompson. She made 3 field goals, all 3 of them for the Tigers. She made 2 2-point baskets, 1 3-pointer, and she's 1 of 1 from the free throw line for 8 points. And all these other points are going to come from the free throw line. 6 points from Mackenzie Crusoe. She shot 6 of 7 from the line. Kennedy Cummins shot 5 of 6 from the line. That's 5 points for her. And then Emily Wilson went 2 for 2. And no one else scored in the first half of basketball. For the Blossoms, you got one player in double figures, Bailey Harris. Just another day on the basketball court for her. Regular averaging a double-double, or averaging double points on the season for the Blossoms. But she has 11. She went 3 of 6 from the floor, 1 of 1 from downtown, and 4 of 4 from the free throw line. So 11 points for her. Leads all scorers. Then it's 7 points for Azaria Hulbert. 6 points for Sierra Kinsmer. And let's see, who else have we got on here? 3 points for Laia DeSales. 2 points for Taylor East off the bench. 2 points for Lindsey Long in the ballgame. And 4 points for Jordan Montgomery. So that was the scoring for you. The Blossoms had 4 other players that played and did not score, but the Blossoms lead it here at halftime. 35-21, our score here at the half. As the Blossoms forced 10 turnovers. They had 14 of their own, but the Blossoms were able to get 9 points off the turnovers. ECU only managed 4 points off of UAM's 14 turnovers, so the Blossoms got back and played defense well. The Blossoms' second chance points had 9, while ECU only had 5 in the ballgame. The Blossoms were 6 offensive rebounds, 13 defensive, 19 total. The Tigers with 11 total rebounds here in the first half, 3 offensive, 8 defense, and only have managed 5 second chance points. We are at halftime, 35-21 our score. Third quarter action is coming your way in just a few moments. Don't forget men's basketball. Around 3 o'clock today, Weevils will take on the Tigers at ECU. We'll have the broadcast for you right here on KHBM 93.7. So if you'll stick around, I invite you to come out. If you're in the area, you want to watch the men's college basketball, or maybe the last half of the women's game, you can come on out and join us here at Steelman Fieldhouse on the UAM campus. Watch some basketball here this afternoon. If you can't make it, well, just keep me on here, and I'll try to keep you updated. Halftime, 35-21. Blossoms have a 14-point lead, the biggest of the game. We'll take a break and be back with more at halftime in a moment. The Blossoms with a 14-point lead. At the end of the first quarter, it was 11-9. Blossoms went on a tear there in the second period and outscored them 24-12. to open up this 14-point lead here at the half. Both teams are back out on the floor taking their preparations for the third quarter. We'll take one more timeout. We'll come back with the start of the third quarter right after this. Five 21, the Blossoms with a 14-point lead. We get set to start the third quarter. It'll be the original starting five for the Blossoms. Kinsmore. Long's out there. You got Bailey Harris, Joy Montgomery, and Azaria Holbert. Tigers will get the basketball, though, to start the third quarter. Blossoms will open up and stay at a man-to-man. They've been in most of the ball game. Tigers working around the perimeter. Try to go to the free throw line. They get it there to Crusoe. Crusoe can't get a shot. Back outside, three-pointer on the way. Good by Izzy coming. Izzy finally gets to make a shot. Three-pointer to start here this second half. Blossom with it. They'll try to answer with a three-pointer from Azaria Hubbard, and it's good. Azaria, her second three of the game. Blossoms back on top by 14 again. 38-24. The drive down the right side of the lane. Shot up, no good. Rebound, Blossoms have it. Coming out of there, it's going to be a Lindsay Hall. Long will bring it across the timeline into the front court. Guarded out there by Izzy Cummins. And they're going to have a check foul called on Izzy Cummins. With a reach touch foul. That is her third personal. First team foul of the third period. 8:51 left to play here in the third quarter. Izzy Cummins will go out, checking in the ball game. Emily Wilson for ECU. And the Blossoms with a fresh 20 on the shot clock. Get it into a Lindsay Long. She'll hand it off to Bailey Harris. Harris drives on the left side, pulls up, gives it out front to Montgomery for three. It won't go. Rebound, Tigers have it. Kate Ogle pulled down the rebound for ECU. They'll set up in their half court offense. They work it already, go down inside. Shot put up, no good. Rebound on the floor. Scramble for it. Tigers come out of there with it. They get it outside to Cummins. Cummins off to Wilson. Wilson back to Mackenzie Crusoe. Crusoe can't go anywhere. 4 seconds to shoot now. Thompson throws up a prayer. Her shot won't go, and the rebound comes off to the Blossoms. Bailey Harris will bring it up the floor. We go under 8 minutes to play in the third. Lindsay Long deep in the right corner. Guarded over there by Kennedy Cummins comes out with a dribble, top of the key, goes left side to Montgomery, back right side to Harris. Harris from the corner on the right side, dribbles across the lane, gives it up to Hulbert. Hulbert shot in the lane, no good, but a whistle and a foul called. An offensive foul called on Azaria Hulbert. Blossoms get it back to him. Hulbert will go sit down. Maya Basales is going to check into the game now for the Blossoms. UAM leading by 14, 38-24. Tigers with the basketball. Kennedy Cummins has a shot blocked by Lindsey Long. Pushed out of there by Montgomery. Down the floor, they get it to Bailey Harris. And Harris runs the floor as good as anybody. She's down the floor on the fast break to get the easy basket. And Blossoms have a 16-point lead now. 40-24. 7:10 to play. Tigers with a three-pointer on the way is good. That's going to be Kate Ogle. Kate Ogle's first field goal of the ball game. 40-27 now. Harris, bounce pass, goes underneath to Kinsmore. Back out front. A Lindsey Long for three is good. Her first three-pointer of the game. Blossoms have five of them in the game and lead it by 16 again. 43-27. Down the corner, another three on the way by Ogle, and it's good. No, that's not Ogle, that's 22, that's Wilson. They've had three different players hit field goals, all of them threes here in the third quarter. Blossoms still lead by 13, 43-30. Montgomery in the corner, it goes left side to Long. Lindsey tried to drive baseline, pulls it back out front to Basales. Wyatt drives in, right-handed jump shot no good. As Kinsmore with the rebound, the putback no good, but a foul is going to be called against the Tigers. Fouls on Ashlyn Evans Thompson. Going to send Sierra Kinsmore to the line for the Blossoms. With 6:06 to play in the third quarter. Joy Montgomery will get a breather, checking in. Going to be Nia Banks. Kinsmore's free throw is up, and it is good. I'll give her 7 points in the ball game. Second free throw on the way. Blossoms are perfect. 8 out of 8 from the line in the ball game today. 45-30, Blossoms by 15. Thompson has it stolen from behind. That's going to be Kinsmore. Kinsmore goes coast to coast, lays it off the glass. Sarah Kinsmore in double figures now with 10, and the Blossoms are up by 17. 47-30. 5:40 to play in the third quarter. And Coach Heather Hurt wants a timeout to talk about it. With 5:40 to play in the third, it's 47-30. Blossoms have the lead. We're back in just a moment. Come out of the timeout. Back 47-30 our score. While we were gone, the Tigers missed a three-pointer. The Blossoms turned it over. Nothing, no harm, no foul. Just eat about 45 seconds off the clock. And we're back to immediate timeout. We'll keep it right here. 47-30 our score. Blossoms have a 17-point lead. That's their biggest of the ball game. Look at the third quarter. Tigers have made more shots in the third period than they made the entire ballgame, but they tied that. They had three field goals in the first half of basketball. Here in the third quarter, they're 3 of 7 now for 43%. All of them have been beyond the arc, so they're 3 of 3 from downtown here in the third quarter, 100%. For the ballgame, the Tigers are shooting 6 of 29, that's 21%. 4 of 14 from beyond the arc, 29%. And they were 14 of 16 from the free throw line, 88%. The Blossoms, on the other hand, are 17 of 34 for the game. That's 50%. They were 5 of 12 from downtown, 42%. And they've been perfect from the free throw line, 8 of 8. The Blossoms have a rebound, out-rebounded them 23 to 13. 7 offensive rebounds, 16 defensive rebounds for the Blossoms. And we come out of the timeout now. It'll be UAM basketball. They'll have it in the backcourt on the floor. It's going to be Lia Basales, Joy Montgomery, Shay Goodwin, along with Nia Banks and Alexis Grice. Montgomery to the right elbow with the dribble back out front. Grice for three from the top of the key, and it's good. Alexis Grice. 15-30, a 20-point lead for the Blossoms. Boy, everybody's feeling it here in the gym today. Tigers with the basketball. Take it right side to Crusoe. Back out around the horn. They'll swing it left side to Wilson. Off the key now to Havens, who just checked in for the Tigers. Down the right side, down the lane, layup up and in. Good, a whistle and a foul called against the Blossoms as Emily Wilson went strong in the basket, got it to go. And a foul going to be called against UAM. He got the foul on Nia Banks. That's two on Nia. At the free throw line, trying to get a three-point play. Here's Emily Wilson. His shot's up, and it's good. That's 5, 6, 9 points on the other end. Watson's on the floor. Bailey Harris puts it up and in. Wow. Bailey with 15 points on the draw. Leading all scores. 52-33. Blossoms lead it. Tigers with the basketball. They work it right side. Get it off to Wilson. Wilson finds inside, finds Kennedy Cummins. Cummins puts it up at end zone. Little pressure in the backcourt now by the Tigers. Blossoms break it, get it across the timeline. Left corner. Going to get it off to Alexis Grice. Top of key to Goodwin. Goodwin to Basales. Back to Grice. Left corner it goes to Montgomery. She'll drive. Goes all the way on the baseline. And she's going to be fouled. As a foul against Gabby. They called it on Tatum Heavens. Foul on her. That'll be team foul number 3 against the Tigers. Blossoms will inbound on the baseline, looking to get it in. They do to Raya Basales. Basales deep in the left corner, comes out on the wing with the dribble, picks it up, needing some help. Somebody's got to come help her. And they call a 5-second call. Blossoms give it right back to him. That'll be turnover number 16 in the ball game against the Blossoms. 11, make it 12 turnovers against the Tigers. Blossoms still lead though, 52-35. Tigers with the basketball. They go to Crusoe. Crusoe guarded there by Bailey Harris. Long pass goes across the court. They'll pull it down, get it out front to Ogle for three. Her shot no good. Rebound, going to be out of bounds. Last touch by who? Says last touch by Lyle Bassells. So Wyatt touched it last. Tigers are good at back. They've got 9 seconds on the shot clock to shoot. Once they hit inbound it, looking to get it in, they finally do. Crusoe to Ogle. Ogle passed up to three. Throws it. Ball batted in the backcourt. They're going to run over and back hard against the Tiger. Blossom's defense really got on them that time. The UAM will get the basketball back. Joy Montgomery, Alindy Wong, Lyle Bassells is out there along with Sierra Kinsmel and Bailey Harris on the floor for the Blossoms. 2:45 left to play in the third. Blossoms lead at 52-35. Long in the corner to Harris. Bailey. Take the shot from 14 with a fadeaway jumper. No good. Rebound. Tigers have it. Pulling it down with Emily Wilson. Wilson gets it ahead to Kennedy Cummins. He'll throw it down. Run the point for it. Puts it left side to Wilson. Wilson drives down the left side. Now gives it up to Crusoe. Puts it up and in. Crusoe. Gives it Crusoe. Her first field goal of the day. 52-37. Blossoms on top. Left corner it goes. Bailey Harris for three, and it's good. Bailey, her second three of the game. Going to give her 18 for the ball game. Seven threes in the game for UAM. It's 55-37. Tigers take it down inside. A throw up, a shot, a whistle, and a foul going to be called against UAM. Let's see what we call a foul on. Foul goes on Lindsey Long. It'll send to the free throw line Emily Wilson. Lyle Bassells will go get a breather. Checking in is going to be Shea Goodwin. Shea will check in on the ball game. At the line for the Tigers, Emily Wilson. She's 4 out of 5 this afternoon shooting free throws. Misses that one off the back of the rim. Still 55-37. Blossoms lead it. A minute 46 to play here in the third. Second free throw's in. Nothing but net on that one. 55-38. Blossoms quickly into the front court. Shea Goodwin takes it all the way down left side of the lane. Gives it up to Long. Long backing away in the lane. Gets it outside to Montgomery. Montgomery has the ball knocked out of her hands on a little out of bounds. Off of the Tigers. Blossoms maintaining possession of it with 18 on the shot clock. Montgomery triggers it in, gets it into Long. Long back to Montgomery. She'll run the point. Now to Goodwin. Goodwin looking for Kinsmel down low. She'll take it in the paint. Running jumper is short. No good. Rebound. Tigers have it. Oh boy. 55-38. Blossoms still lead. Tigers with it in the front court. Tatum Havens. Havens off to Wilson. Back now to Izzy Cummins. Cummins directing traffic. Long three-pointer by Ogles is on the way. It won't go. And there's Shea Goodwin to pull down the rebound. Under a minute left to go here in the third quarter. Blossoms with the basketball. Goodwin down the right side of the lane. Picked up her dribble. Finally gives it up to Bailey Harris. 16 to shoot. Harris going to back up near the emblem at midcourt. Goes around the screen from Kinsmel. Gives it back to her at the free throw line. Now to Montgomery. Montgomery flashing the lane at the buzzer. Puts it up in the end. As the shot clock was winding down, Joy Montgomery got the pass. Goes up for the bucket. Blossoms up 57-38. There's a three-pointer on the way by the Tigers. Put no good. Rebound Blossoms had it. With 12 seconds left in the third quarter. Coach Midler, he's up wanting them to move. 5 seconds. Montgomery penetrates, gets it left side to Bailey Harris. Harris goes with a shot. She's going to be fouled. She'll get to go to the free throw line with less than 1 second to go. Kennedy Cummins is going to get the foul. And Bailey Harris is going to shoot a couple of free throws. Wow. fouled her with less than 1 second to go here at the end of the third quarter. Bailey Harris for the Blossoms at the line with 18 points in the ball game. She's a perfect 4 out of 4 from the line this afternoon. First one's up, she misses up. First miss from the free throw line for the Blossoms. They went 8 of 8 before that miss. Second free throw, she makes that. So make it 58-38 as the end of the third quarter becomes here. We've got the fourth quarter coming. Blossoms with a 20-point lead, 58-38. We're back with the fourth quarter in just a moment. Blossoms with a 20-point lead. That's her biggest lead of the ball game. They had about 14 at the half and stretched that out here as they've outscored them 23-17 in the third quarter. Tigers are now 9 of 38. That's 24% shooting. 4 of 18 from downtown and 16 of 19 from the free throw line. The Blossoms, 21 of 40, 53%. 7 of 14, shooting 50% from beyond the arc, and 9 of 10 from the free throw line for 90%. Out-rebounded them 26-17. Turnovers, 13 for the Tigers, 17 for the Blossoms. That's been the only downfall this afternoon when you look at stats is the number of turnovers the Blossoms have had. But if you look at it, the Blossoms have turned those 13 turnovers by ECU into 14 points. The Tigers, on the other hand, have 417 turnovers, but have only gotten 4 points out of it. As we get set to start the fourth quarter, let's see who all we got on the floor. Alenzie Long, Azaria Hulbert, Joy Montgomery, Bailey Harris, and Sierra Kinsmill on the floor for the Blossoms. Blossom took the basketball to start the fourth quarter. In the corner, they get it to Montgomery for three. It's off the mark. No good. Rebound. Going to be chased down by the Tigers as they get it. Thompson up the floor. Goes all the way down underneath. Tries a shot. It's blocked by Kinsmore. Tigers keep it alive. Now a three-point shot on the way is no good. And we got a whistle and a foul on the floor called before the shot. As the foul is going to go against, I believe it went against Lindsay Long. Yeah, that's her fourth personal foul. Nia Banks is going to come off the bench quickly and get Lindsay out of there. A four foul. Tigers will inbound on the baseline. 9.5 minutes to play in this basketball game. Blossoms lead it by 20. Tigers with it. Gabby Cummins. Leaves it out front to Izzy Cummins. Go back right side to Gaddy. Gaddy trying to get it inside. They do to Crusoe. Crusoe, left-handed shot blocked by Bailey Harris, and Bailey takes it out of the air. Harris with the basketball into the front court. Gives it up to Banks. Banks to the elbow, right side, now backs it out beyond the arc. Left side to Montgomery. Montgomery to Hulbert, almost had on the left wing. Inside the three-point line. Drives, goes in the lane. They call an offensive foul. Blocking foul called against Sarah Kinsmore. It'll be her third. They give the ball back to the Tigers. Under 9 minutes to play now with Rossum for the 20-point lead. Here on the other end, they call an offensive foul on the other end. On Izzy Cummins, a blocking foul. That is got to be three on her. We got a timeout on the floor with a little about 8.5 minutes to play. 58-38 our score. Blossoms lead it by 20. We'll be back after this timeout. Blossoms with a 20-point lead. It'll be UAM basketball as we come out of the timeout. Joy Montgomery, Azaria Hulbert, Nia Banks, Sierra Kinsmull, and Bailey Harris on the floor for UAM. Blossoms into the front court. Montgomery gives it up to Harris out on the left wing. Out beyond the arc, right side. Now they swing it over to Banks. Nia in the corner to Montgomery. Back out front to Nia. She's open for a three, but let's see, there's a whistle and a foul called before that. I believe against, foul went against Tatum Haven. That'll be team foul number three against the Tigers here in the fourth quarter. Blossoms inbound it, get it in, they got it to Banks, now to Hulbert. Hulbert drives baseline. Cut off nicely there. Back in the corner, it goes to Banks for three. Her shot won't go. Rebound. Scramble for it on the floor. We're going to call a whistle and a foul called on Joy Montgomery, I believe. Yep. It was a scramble for the basketball. They're going to nab Joy with a tie, with a foul. Score still 58-38. Blossoms lead it by 20. Blossoms have led almost the entire ball game. One time the Tigers led was before the game. It was a technical foul call against the Blossoms. There's a three-pointer on the way by McKenzie. Up by number 12. That's Izzy Cummins. 58-41. Blossoms still on top, though. Hulbert gets it to Banks. Banks floater on the baseline. Yes. Nia Banks, her first 2 points of the afternoon. Blossoms on top by 19 now. Here's a drive baseline by the Tigers. Shot won't go. Nia Banks goes high to get a rebound. The Blossoms can take their biggest lead into the front court with a basket here at this time into the front court. Montgomery with the dribble, lost the handle on it. It goes off the foot of a Tiger. So we'll stay with UAM with 19 on the shot clock. Shea Goodwin's going to check in. Laya Bassells will check in for the Blossoms. Zaria Hulbert and Montgomery will sit down. Blossoms looking to get it in. Get it into Bassells. Bassells to Banks. Banks out to Goodwin. Goodwin, 14-foot jumper from the right elbow. No good. Offensive rebound. The putback no good, but a foul called against ECU. As the foul went against number 12. That's Izzy Cummins. And at the free throw line, it's going to be Sierra Kinsmull. Kinsmull with the free throw is on the way, and it's good. Fouling out of the ball game, Tatum Havens is fouled out for the Tigers. That one more free throw coming for Sarah Kinsmore. It's up and it's good. The Blossoms lead it by 21. The biggest lead of the ball game comes with 7:05 to play in the fourth quarter. Tigers with it, front court. Izzy Cummins drives, left-handed layup, good. And Izzy made that look too easy. She got 5 points in the ball game, and at 62-43, Blossom still lead. Goodwin gives it up to Banks in the corner. Banks back out top of the key now to Lia Basales. Back to Goodwin. Go inside the paint to Kinsmore. Outside to Harris on the right side. Bailey drives. Back out front to Basales. Lia Basales for three. It's no good. A whistle and a over the back to be called against. Nope, they're going to call the Tigers for the foul. They call a foul on Kennedy Cummins. Her third personal. This team foul number four against the Tigers. Blossom will inbound it on the baseline. They'll throw it in, get it into Basales. Lyup gives it up to Goodwin. Goodwin cross-court pass now to Montgomery. Montgomery drives the baseline. Shot is blocked. A foul called against the Tigers. So the foul goes against ECU. It's going to go against Kennedy Cummins. That's her fourth personal foul. Going to put it to the free throw line. Nia Banks. 2 points in the game for her. She has not shot a free throw. Misses the first one. Still 62-43. Blossoms lead it by 19. We've got 6:23 to play in the game. Banks will try to collect the second free throw. It's up and no good. Missed them both. Tigers come down with a rebound. They'll bring it up the floor. Thompson trying to go inside the lane. Throws it out of bounds. Looks like trying to hit Kennedy Cummins inside the lane and just missed everybody. Goes through and out of bounds. Blossoms get it back. Be another turnover against the Tigers. Turnover getting close to being even. 18 for UAM, 15 for the Tigers. Here's Kinsmore, left-handed. A left side of the lane, little 12-foot jumper. Good. You see her shoot from out there much. She's got 14 points on the day. Blossoms lead it by 21 again. Three-point shot up by the Tigers. Will not go. Blossoms gets a rebound. Shay Goodwin off to Basales. Basales back to Goodwin at the top of the key. She'll drive to the free throw line. In the paint, fadeaway jumper is short. And going to be saved in bounds by Lia Basales. Goodwin collects it back to Basales in the corner. She'll try a three. It won't go. Bailey Harris got the offside rebound. Has it knocked out of her hands. A scramble for it. It's going to go out of bounds off of Bailey Harris. So the Tigers are going to get it back with 5:25 to play in the ballgame. 64-43. UAM has the lead. All right, Jay Goodman will sit down. Kinsmore sits down. Long comes back in, along with Alexis Grice and Taylor East on the floor for the Blossoms. Tigers working around, three-point shot on the way. A short, no good. Lindsey Long chases down a rebound in the corner, gets double-teamed, has it taken away. And a drive toward the basket, a foul called on Lia Basales. Long got the rebound, but got caught over there in the corner. And she did, the Tigers collapsed on her. Basales picks up the foul. At the free throw line for the Tigers is going to be Izzy Cummins. First one's on the way, and it's good. 5:03 left to play. 64-45 as Cummins got them both to go. Cuts the lead down to 19 again. Alexis Grice fires a quick three. In and out, no good. Bailey Harris with the offensive rebound. Bailey Harris with 21 points on the day leads the all scorers. Here's a three-pointer on the other end by the Tigers. Put up good by Izzy Cummins. Her second three of the game. She's got 8 points. They get 10 points. She's in double figures. All of it here in the fourth quarter. Blossom for the basketball. Lindsey Long. Long looking for Harris. Slashing the lane. Couldn't get it to her. Goes out to Basales. Basales finds Taylor East in the lane. Her turnaround jumper will not go. Ball goes out of bounds. Last touch by the Blossoms. We're down to 4:16 left to go here in the fourth quarter. Blossoms pretty much cruise control. 66-48, our score. Another quick three on the left side. No good. Rebound. Out of bounds. Last touch by Lionel LaSalle. Nope. Saved by UA, by the Tigers. It's going to be UAM basketball. 4:04 left to play. Montgomery checks back in for the Blossoms, and Bailey Harris will go sit down. Quickly, UAM comes up the floor. They'll get it into Basales. Basales to Alexis Grice. Grice, bounce pass underneath. Taylor East puts it up and in. Taylor East. First fourth point of the afternoon, 68-48. Blossoms back on top by 20. Tigers try to take it inside. Izzy Cummins double team down low. They'll kick it back in the left corner. A three-pointer too hard, will not go. Alexis Grice gets the rebound. Grice gets it ahead to Basales. Basales back to Grice. 3:24 to play. Joy Montgomery with the dribble. Goes down along the left side of the lane. Kicks it back out front to Long. 10 to shoot for the Blossoms. They go to Grice out on the right wing. Lost a handle on it. Stolen by the Tigers. All the way down the floor. Cummins goes in. Puts a shot up. Good. Izzy Cummins. She got 10, 12 points. All of them here in the fourth quarter for the Tigers. Makes it 68-50. Still an 18-point lead for UAM. Under 2:50 to play now in the quarter, in the fourth quarter. Grice to Basales to Montgomery. Montgomery at the top of the key. Backs it up near the UAM emblem at midcourt. Tries to work around the screen from East. Goes down the right side of the lane. Throws a shot up, no good, but a whistle and a foul called against the Tigers. As it'll send Joy Montgomery to the free throw line. And the foul goes against Kennedy Cummins. That's her fifth personal foul. She will foul out. Becomes the second Tiger to foul out this afternoon. Joy Montgomery going to be at the line for UAM. 2 out of 2 for Joy. 6 points in the ball game. First one is up and off the front of the rim. No good. One more free throw to go with 2:34 left to play. Montgomery's second one is good. So 69-50. Montgomery will go sit down. Torrey Hamilton will check back in. Hamilton comes in. Tigers with it in the front court. Blossom staying a man-to-man. Tigers working left side. Out to Ogles. Ogles. Top of the key to get it to Cummins for three. Gabby shot no good. Rebound. Torrey Hamilton had it. Got it knocked out of her hand. It'll stay with the Blossoms. And they'll have it in the backcourt. Lia Vassell is going to get a breather as Azari Hulbert checks back in. So the Blossoms with Banks, Goodwin, Grice, Hulbert, and Hamilton on the floor for the Blossoms. You get it to Grice. Grice, short shot is short. Rebound, saved in by Azaria Hulbert. To get it to Grice, she'll go down the left side of the lane. Count it and one. Oh, my. Alexis Grice just took off down the lane, got the basket to go, and draws a foul. So Alexis, with 5 points, going to be at the line trying to complete a three-point play here. And give the Blossoms their biggest lead of the afternoon. They lead it by 21 at the moment. Free throws up. It's good. 22-point lead now for UAM with a minute 50 here in this one. Blossoms fall back in a man-to-man. And Tigers working around the perimeter. Ogles looking up the right side. Gabby Cummins. Cummins drop the key to Belcher. Belcher bounce pass goes into Cummins again at the free throw line. Now outside it comes to Gabby Cummins. Off to Izzy. Izzy driving left side of the lane. A reach-in foul going to be called against against the Blossoms. Foul is going to go on Tori Hamilton. That'll be her first. Fourth team foul, making it the fifth team foul against the Blossoms. And at the line, it'll be Izzy Cummins for ECU, shooting two shots here. First one's on the way, off the further rim, no good. We got a buck and a half left to go. Blossoms lead it by 22. Second free throw's up, it's no good. Tori Hamilton collects the rebound. And here come the Blossoms. Holbert in the corner to Hamilton. There's a whistle, we'll see, away from the basketball. It'll be a blocking foul called against the Tigers. Izzy Cummins. And it will send Azaria Holbert to the free throw line. Okay. So Azaria at the free throw line. First one's up and no good. A minute 21 left to play. Azaria Holbert is at the free throw line. She'll try to collect the second free throw. It's up and bounces in good. Went high in the air and fell back through the cylinder. 73-50, Blossoms lead it by 23. The biggest lead of the day is a three-point shot on the way as an air ball by the Tigers. They keep it alive, however. Get it outside to Ogle for three. It won't go. Finally, Tori Hamilton collects the rebound for the Blossoms. She'll give it up to Shea Goodwin. They'll bring it up the floor for the Blossoms. Under a minute now left to go. Goodwin leaves it with Banks. Naya takes the dribble down the right side of the lane. Goes in the corner to Holbert. Top of the key to Goodwin. 10 to shoot. They get it to Grice. Grice passed up the three. 7 to shoot. In the corner to Banks. Banks shot blocked. And Tigers were going to get it. Now it's knocked out of bounds. It's the last touch by the Tigers. The UAM will get it back. Wow. With 33 seconds remaining, Blossom's going to get the basketball back, leading 23 points, 73-50. Get it into Goodwin. There's about 12 seconds difference between shot clock and game clock. Hamilton started to shoot the three. Ogle contested it, and she traveled with the basketball. She pulled it back down, didn't get the shot off. So the shot clock is off now. 26 seconds remain in this one. Tigers will work it out here on the perimeter. They get it to Gabby Cummins. Fires a three, and it's good. Cummins, her second three of the game. Blossoms going to have to get it across midcourt. They do as Azaria Holbert comes across. That gives it up to Goodwin. And that's going to be your ball game. Blossoms are going to click two in a row now. They'll go to 3-5 in conference play. The Tigers are going to fall to 1-7 in conference play. As the final score here is 73-53. The Blossoms come up huge here in the second half. And then by 14 at halftime, they're 35-21. Final score here is 73-53. The Blossoms get the win. Congratulations go out to David Kidley, an assistant coach for Melissa Webb, as the Blossoms make it two in a row. And they get the win here this afternoon. Coach Midlick and the team celebrating out there at midcourt. We'll give him a second to make his way over here and join us. I'm sure about the only thing that he's not going to be happy with is going to be the amount of turnovers the Blossoms had as in the ballgame. They're approaching 20 turnovers, but they forced as many as 14. And again, our final score, 73-53. And we're waiting on the final stats to come over our way. We'll start. And we've got men's action coming up here in about 20, 25 minutes from now. So I hope you'll join us for that. And I didn't get a final stat. Coach Midland. He's excited. They're all still celebrating over there on the sideline as they got the win. We'll take a break. We'll come back, try to wrap this one up for you here from Steelman Fieldhouse in just a moment.